Mobile Geek's coverage of IFA 2014 is powered by Asus and Mercedes-Benz.
Hi there, this is Stu from Mobile Geeks, and we're at the ZTE product launch at IFA 2014 here in Berlin. And here we can see in front of me, we have the three products that ZTE is launching onto the European and German markets in the forthcoming weeks and months. So first of all, over here on the left, we have what's known as the ZTE Blade 3G. This is a 3G version of the phone. On the right here, we have the 4G version. If we just compare the two, you'll see that the 4G is ever so slightly larger, not that much. Bigger, but just slightly, and they're both running 5-inch screens, above 720p. The 4G actually runs a 1.2 gigahertz quad core, and the 3G, interestingly, runs a 1.3 gigahertz quad core. They both have 2,300 milliamp hour batteries, and they both run Android 4.4. On the front, you get an 8 megapixel camera on both of these guys. The main difference is not only the fact that one is, well, this 4G guy is LTE compatible, and will be retailing for around 430 euros when it comes to market. It's got a kind of fiberglass back, and it actually looks reasonably good. This is the 8 megapixel camera right here, I should say. I think we get a 2 megapixel on the front. The 3G version will be considerably cheaper, actually, at only 180 euros when it comes to market. And again, it has the same fiberglass kind of design on the back and a little ZTE logo here, same 8 megapixel camera. But for me, the most interesting thing to be launched here today at ZTE is this guy. This is the ZTE Kis 3 Max. Now this is gonna hit the German market for a price of only 99 euros, which is pretty phenomenal really when you think about it. It's got a 1.3 gigahertz dual core MediaTek chip, and it's a 4.5 inch screen. It is like a TN screen, it's not LCD, it's not IPS. The view angles aren't exactly fantastic, but having said that, I mean, for a 99 euro phone, it's not that bad. It's got a Android 4.4.2, and you're getting a 480 by 854 pixels, which is a slightly odd kind of size. So it's not 720p like its larger brothers, but it's still a decent looking device. Now, I haven't spoken to ZTE here today. They're saying that their strategy overall is to introduce these very affordable phones into the market so that the German and European consumers can have a taste of what they can do at the very entry level. They also say that they will progress into the more higher end and mid-range phones, but that the key component right now is to gain consumer trust. And they believe that the entry level, the very affordable Android smartphone segment is the right place to do that. And I have to say, I'm very reasonably impressed with these devices, especially this guy for only 99 euros. Hi, this is Stu. So this is Stu from Mobile Geek signing off. And if you like this stuff, make sure you subscribe to our channel. We're on Facebook, we're on Twitter. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. What?